Hey, Rembo here, and welcome to my channel. Today, I want to talk a little bit more about this bike right here, the Ducati Multistrada V4, and in this case, it's the Pikes Peak. Don't forget that I had a V4S that I put about 27,000 miles on it, not quite 28,000 miles on it, and really enjoyed it. But as you folks know, I test ride and give reviews on a lot of bikes. Pretty much every Ducati that they make, a bunch of Triumph, and I've had some other stuff in there, some Harleys and so on and so forth. And I think that there's no surprise that I am a fan of Ducati. And the interesting part is I really never was in the past. But this bike in particular, I'm gonna give you a little insight. I was looking for another bike that I can do longer touring type stuff on, and Ducati wasn't even on my list, to be quite honest with you. So I went to the Triumph dealer, who's also Ducati, and I wanted to look at the different Tiger options that they had. And it was Ian from Two Wheels World, the Ducati name is Ducati Forza, who's like, hey, they came out with this new Multistrada, and you know, in my mind I'm like, ah, another Ducati, I'm not getting a valve job every, you know, 7500 miles. And he's like, no, he goes, dude, it's like 60,000 kilometers or like 36,000 miles before you need the valves. And I'm like, what? So I said, okay, I'm intrigued. And that's what got me started initially on my journey with Ducati. I just wanted to be able to just take longer trips. That's really what this all started about. It just really started with me taking longer trips, which led me down that path. I had the Indian Scout Bobber. I was going to keep that and then have this for longer trips, have my Indian Scout Bobber for going back and forth to work and for just, you know, little bouncing around commuting and for fun. Unfortunately, 6 days before my V4S was delivered, I was hit head on when I was at an intersection and my bike was totaled. I was fine. There's a video about that you guys can find. It doesn't really matter. But that's what got me started. And so my very first Ducati was a Ducati Multistrada V4S. And then I got to take out a 1260 and I really understood the difference between the two. And it really was this weekend when I took out a Street Fighter that I realized what a total package this thing is. I mean, if you're going to be doing some off-road stuff, the V4S is certainly the bike for you. If you want a little more bells and whistles as far as the you know, touring capabilities, it comes with more for less money than the V4S is certainly the choice. But if you want something that's really spirited and you want something that you could take to the track, I've taken this, I've done a track day with this. I've done a 3,000 mile round trip to Texas with it. I've done everyday riding with it. So it was riding a Street Fighter that made me realize, wow, this is great, but how impractical is the Street Fighter for like long trips? It's a very niche specific. Where this bike, I mean, it lives up to its name, Multistrada, you know, many roads. And, you know, like this is the bike. If I only could, if I was only allowed to have one motorcycle, and I have two right now, for now, it would be this one. And I'm not really doing a lot of off-road, so I don't need the V4S. The rally's coming out, which I cannot wait to get my claws into that rally. I'm gonna be honest with you, I really cannot wait to get my claws into that rally so I can you know, do some testing on it and really see how it feels, because it's a completely different suspension, the bigger bags. I just really want to get my claws into that and do a review of that. Unfortunately, even the ones that are pre-sold haven't arrived yet at the dealer. So the Multistrada and the Pikes Peak version, yeah, it's a little bit more money, but it's kind of like having a sport bike and a touring bike all in one, hence the sport touring. Because, you know, I rode it today and I had some fun. I'm not going to say I obeyed all the rules today. And it just made me realize that people do not understand just how fast this bike is and how powerful this bike is and how nimble this bike is. And especially with these Marcassini rims here, there's a lot less unsprung weight than the V4S. So if you're on the fence between a V4S and the V4 Pikes Peak, it's really going to come down to what kind of riding you do. If you're coming from, for example, a 1250, you know, R1250 GSA, well, then the rally is certainly going to be calling your name with that 8-gallon tank and so on and so forth. But if you want a Ducati to feel like you're riding a Ducati, to have that sound, to have that grit, and to have really all the bells and whistles, this is the best bike I've ever owned in my entire life. And I know this might sound like a commercial. I've had my problems with the V4S. I've had a few issues with this. Warranty, taking care of it. And, you know, it's easy. You have a warranty, they take care of it, you're done. Okay? And Ducati has really stood behind this bike significantly. But riding all of these kind of bikes, it's like this is all of those bikes in one. Minus off-road stuff, of course, with the, you know, the Pikes Peak version. So I guess what I'm trying to say is you really only need one bike. You can do long distance touring, you can pack it up, you can take it to the track, you can have fun during the day. But if you're buying it just to commute in heavy traffic, yeah, it's not the bike for you. Go get a Trident 660 or something like that from Triumph, you know, a Triumph Trident, that nice 333 and that Trident 660. I love that bike. That's great for bouncing around town and commuting, good gas mileage. But if you want a bike that does everything, get the Pikes Peak. Like I said, unless of course you're going to do some off-road, and I know some people have, and I've mentioned this multiple times, if you're buying one of a bike like this and you're worried about gas mileage, it's the wrong bike for you. I can run this thing and get 25 to 26 miles to the gallon, like running it hard doing a track day, or I can really take my time on the highway and push 40 miles to the gallon. Overall, I probably average about 32. It depends, you know, what kind of mood I'm in, because your right wrist determines everything for this bike. But the only thing I want to say is that I am super happy with this bike. This is the bike that is probably giving me the most joy, other than me looking back at my life at all the bikes that I've had, and especially when I was younger and out in the woods and having a lot of fun in the dirt. If I want to go out in the dirt and do a dirt track, I want to buy a dirt bike. I'm not one of these guys like, you know, that the Brett Dukakis guy, you know, who goes out on all of these trips off-road, or Itchy Boots, who does everything as much as possible in the dirt. I'm on the road. I'm in Florida. I want to go to the Twisties. I want to take this to California. I want to take this to North Carolina, Tennessee, you know, that whole area up there. I can take this bike. I can take it on a long, boring ride. It is really living up to its name, Multistrada. So I just want to say, in the last, and I'm not joking, this December will be 50 years since I got my first motorcycle. And by far, this bike has absolutely been the best, the absolute best. And like I said, every bike has their problems. I've had problems with the V4S, fixed. As I said previously, I've had some issues with this, fixed, not a problem. Is it the perfect bike? No bike's the perfect bike. And if you're aware of a perfect bike, then you should own it, I guess is the best way to put it. Anyway, this is Rembo. Please like, please subscribe. I'd appreciate it. Thank you very much, and have a good day. Bye-bye.